this video will focus on the accessory organs. So just some general things in terms of the accessory organs that you should be familiar with. First off, accessory glands include the salivary glands, the liver, the gallbladder, and the pancreas. When I say liver, that would include the gallbladder. Accessory glands are going to secrete products via some ducts. So question for you, would these be considered exocrine glands or endocrine glands? Hopefully, you said exocrine glands, because exocrine glands are associated with ducts. So each of these accessory organs will secrete certain products. We'll talk about what products those are and when they are secreted into the lumen of the gastrointestinal tract. So in general, the salivary glands are going to secrete saliva and a few other things. The pancreas secretes pancreatic juice, and there's a lot of components that make up the pancreatic juice that we'll discuss. And the liver secretes bile, which plays a fundamental role in the digestion of fats. To begin, here's the general structure of an accessory gland. So remember, the liver, the pancreas, and salivary glands are all accessory glands. So in this image here, what you are looking at is a cross-section through one of those accessory glands. Here's the duct associated with these accessory glands. Again, these are types of exocrine glands. They have cells called acini cells, which are also called acinar cells. So let's look at how these acinar cells are going to work. The acinar cells secrete fluid, which could be enzymes, water, inorganic ions, or other solutes. And when they secrete these things, which are indicated by the arrows here, they are going to flow through the duct. When they flow through the duct, they can be modified. And then after they're modified, the modified secretion enters the lumen of the GI tract. So that's the basic structure of the accessory glands.